This week's Parsha includes the second Parsha, the second section of Shema. We had last week's Parsha included Vahavta Hashem Elokecha, the first part of Shema, and now we have Vahaya, which is the second one. And if you notice, the first Parsha of Shema is in the singular, and the second one is in the plural. Just as an example, when it talks about wearing the tefillin, it says to wear it on your hand, al yadecha, in the first parsha. Whereas the second one, it talks about it in the plural, al yadchem. And the entire paragraph, one is in singular and one is in plural. Why? The Vilna Gaon points out that the first paragraph of Shema doesn't deal with anything involved with the physical world. We're not planting, we're not farming, we're not harvesting. It's all about the spiritual realm. The second parsha talks about working the field, getting crops, God blessing us in the physical realm. The Vilna Gaon says the first paragraph of Shema is talking about elite individuals, unique individuals in each generation, who are focused exclusively on the spiritual leaders of the generation. The second paragraph is talking about everybody else in the nation of Israel who have to work, who have to earn a living, who have to be very engaged in the physical world. The first paragraph is in singular. There's very few people who can be in that exclusively spiritual realm. The second paragraph is in plural because it's talking to the masses. However, we are not a people who says it's the rabbis who focus on the spiritual, they'll take care of everything religious, and we'll do our physical things. No. The second paragraph also talks about the spiritual realm. It talks about wearing tefillin. It talks about mezuzah. It talks about teaching our children Torah. Because yes, we are, the masses has to be involved in the physical world, but they have to balance that together with the spiritual. And they have a place in the Shema as well. That is what we have to learn from that first paragraph and second paragraph of Shema. Every generation will have its individuals, and we should recognize who they are, who will focus exclusively on learning Torah, on praying, on the spiritual realm. But everyone else, the Hamon Am as we call it, they have to be engaged in the physical, but balance that together with the spiritual. And they must also be engaged in mitzvah observance, they must be studying Torah, and the blessings that the nation receives are mostly dependent on them, on what the masses are doing. Let's look at this paragraph of Shema, the second one in particular, which speaks to all of us, and remind ourselves, go to work, be involved in the physical world, but make sure that we're balancing that with the spiritual world, and recognize that the blessings that God gives to our nations are ultimately really dependent on us, on the masses who are balancing the two. Wishing everyone a Shabbat Shalom.